All right, are you ready to do some rear?
Yes!
Rear end work? Let's get rid of this light, which is like making a glare on the camera. We're only gonna need one today, all right? So what we have here is the Subaru factory oil. Okay, get the other ones. Now I went with factory. It's like 10 or 11 bucks a quart. All the aftermarket a lot of people use is like 16 to 20 or 22 a quart on Amazon I was looking at. So I decided super cheaper. I definitely trust Subaru. Come on, it's the factory stuff. And it's almost half the price of the other stuff. So that's why I went with the Subaru choices. I clearly asked him, are you sure there's no difference in the transmission slash front versus the rear diff? He said there's no difference. Some people mentioned something about the NS version of a red line and stuff for the tranny, but not for the rear end. So that's a little confusing because the dealer said that there is no difference in the oils between those two diffs. So I'm just going to do the rear end today because I went all the way to the dealer to buy a new washer for the tranny T70 drain plug, and they didn't have any in stock, and he said he has never sold one, literally. So to me, that tells me I can reuse the old one. I'm sure I can because of the low miles anyway.
I can't see the picture.
You don't need to see the picture. I have it turned off. So, but I'm not going to touch the tranny tonight until I get a little more input from all you guys. And I have a nice pump tool here, which is pretty sweet. So, we're doing the rear end. It's 0.8 quarts. And a couple, you just use your basic half-inch ratchet. I do have the car balanced up in the air. It is up in the air, but it is balanced on four jack stands to make sure I got the level right. It isn't that big a deal, but I wanted to just make sure it's right. What are you doing? Oh, I didn't turn on those extra spotlights yet.
Ready,
ready, there we go. So I'm gonna go under and try and break these loose to start with. Always break loose the top one first. You know why that is, of course. If you break the bottom one, you take the bottom one off, right? You drain all your fluid, then something happens in the top and you can't get it out or off. You have no way to fill the tranny. I mean, fill the rear end, whatever it is. So you always do the top one first to make sure you can fill, then you do the bottom one. So we're gonna try and see if we can break these things loose. All right. The hardest thing here will be getting enough traction to get these things moving. This light is right in my face. I mean, dang, I think it'd almost be better if I can pull. Yeah, if I can pull instead of push. But see, I have like no room. That's the problem with this crap. Ugh. I'm gonna have to do probably the old trick I learned a while back, which you can actually see in my 2005 playlist WRX. Or no, that's, I don't think I had a video for that. I had a write-up for that on the forums, a write-up for the oil change on the 2005 WRX, same stuff. Leverage master. I already got it broken loose, and you use a jack when you have limited space to assist with your movement. I think I got it now. Yep, I got it. Okay. Man, that's tight. Okay, there it comes. I may get some dribble out of the top, but maybe not. Shit. Okay, a little drip. I mean, it looks crystal clean, but you know, I'll find out when I put the take out the rear, the bottom plug, and I'll look at the grindings. I mean, I figure it'd be clean. It's only 20,000 miles. That's another thing I didn't mention. Most people might do it at 30. Of course, I'm a little bit more uptight, I guess is a word I could use. So I'm doing it 20,000 to replace the oils. Make sure it's freshy, minty fresh, cherry minty. Now I gotta see if I can get this one out now that we're safe to do a refill. I'm gonna try the jack method with the other plug, only by hand. Only by hand is all you need. And it'll just eventually pop. Let me get a little bit of a pull. I think I'm almost there, if it didn't pop already. There. See, it snaps loose. And you know how hard that is by hand? It's pretty hard.
It is?
There. I got it loose. I'd never get enough torque on those, and I'd also wreck my shoulders, which are in bad shape. So you use the tools. Now I'll carefully release the pressure. Okay. Off the jack. Pull out the long ratchet. Get the jack out of the way. Take my short one, which it may still be kind of tight.
What is a jack? What jack is
it? This is the jack. It's the thing that pumps up the car. All right. Oh man. That thing is like, it's a small ratchet. I don't have much play. Okay, there we go. That was tough. Now you make sure your thing gets under there. We're gonna spill a lot. Okay, it may squirt out a little bit. I'll give it a little play over here. Now it's hand tight. There are no washers or Teflon tape on any of this needed. Okay, we're gonna unscrew it and you stand back. Don't get splashed in the eye. I'm about to, well, I'm closer. Okay, here we go. And let me get the camera even better. Oh, okay, how's that? That's a nice view right there. Okay. Whew. Okay, it's a little bit dirtier. We'll take a closer look at this thing in a minute. It's a
what
little.
Are you doing that?
So the rear diff takes 0.8 quarts, I guess it is, not liter, it's quarts. 0.8 quarts. This actually doesn't look too bad at all compared to some I've seen, but I still want to get it on a rag and give you a real nice view of what we have here and how much was on it. Then it's really easy. I'm going to clean some of that gunk on the hole, clean everything up, put the bottom screw back in, then fill it with the pump tool. And that's how quick a rear end change can be. That's the easy one. The trannies, just a little more hassle. You got a dipstick to fill through and all that, and a T70 Torx to drain with. But for the rear end, it's so simple. You know, why not bang that one out real quick in a mini project? Then worry about your more complex project up front. Take a little more time than this. All right, guys, let's take a look at this on a white rag. Whoa, is that? That's not metal, it's just, you know, extra crust. Let me see, I can probably, yeah, I can just break it. It's just, it's probably actually some kind of sealer they threw in the bottom that got a little harder. That's probably UPS. Oh, UPS just arrived with my Perrin mod. Be right back. All right, that's taken care of. Let's get back to work. Okay, just gonna get the rest of this off. It's mostly sealer, but you know, there's a lot of metal junk in there. See that? Then you clean it super nice, so it's super crystal. That's UPS.
I mean, who's in the car?
UPS. That's the dude's name, Mr. UPS. You got like dinner on your face too. All right, here.
Ew.
Oh yeah, it's dirty, oops, forgot. Here's an old snotty rag. Here you go. No, we want it. It doesn't matter. You're snotty. So it's all the same. Okay. So we're going to really clean that out.
Take a video of you.
No, then they can't see right. Why'd you do that? Oh, beautiful. Look how beautiful I got that thing. Look how cherry it looks.
Ooh. Cherry?
Isn't it cherry?
I think so.
Cherry! Okay, now I'm going to clean the holes and see where we're at. So I show 36 foot-pounds for both of these plugs. So I'll put in the drain one first. Then grab a rag with my foot. Okay, first I'll torque this one. It could be a little hard, except it's much harder to take off than put back on, because of the glue sealer stuff we saw, that chunky grit, that's just like the paste that they put on the threads. And a lot of people have done this and they didn't have to do anything. It doesn't leak, don't worry about it. If it leaks, I'll just put some Teflon on it later, no big deal. But it's not gonna leak, I already know that. So I'm gonna do 35 foot on this, then I gotta remember to fill it before I put the top plug in. You can see it's only 0.8 quarts, very little. It's definitely not minty clear and fresh, you can see. It has some grunge to it. What the hell? Let me get a rag. Oh, I got a rag right here. So, it's fairly clear, but you can kind of see, look at the different traces of color. That's just, you know, contamination and things like that. So I'm definitely glad. It's just peace of mind to get these brand new minty clear see-through fluid in there. See that? And then this brown gunky junk, just to make sure it's fresh. So let me go ahead and get going. All right, I'm using a 3/8 torque wrench to 37 foot-pounds because 36 is the torque. And I always like to go one more, like 11. So that was a reference to Spinal Tap. And, my half-inch torque wrench is, again, clearance issues, so it'll be much easier to get the torque with this nice small one. I made sure I tightened down the lock on all of these is different. Some have a little clip here, which I like the best. It snaps right into place. Some, you gotta tighten up the center nub, and that's affecting the torque. So I even put a screwdriver in the hole and make sure it's extra tight so it doesn't slip. Then you know you gotta... I mean, these are old anyway. Who knows? From the way I torque them, they all still feel accurate, but who knows, you know? Who really knows? So I just got to get a 36 on this puppy. Oh, yeah. And you only want to hold it at the bottom. Sometimes I make that mistake getting more leverage. That's it already. See, it's easy. All right. I mean, I could overdo it and go to 38, but I'll stop there. I can always upgrade it later if I want it tighter or if I need to fix anything. So I'm sure that's absolutely fine. Now I will put this back in because no doubt I'm going to be leaking some nice fresh fluid out of this thing, and you want to still be able to catch it. All right, let's get that in there. Hell, no, I don't need to go over the exhaust. All right. See if we can get anything. Perfect. Killer. You pump until it pours out. Basic stuff. This is technique is probably 100 years old. You pump until it pours. You don't need to catch it real quick and tap it. It will drain naturally till it stops dripping is the perfect height. However, I don't know anybody that waits for it to stop dripping. You know, it doesn't hurt to have a millimeter extra fluid in there. But this is supposed to be 0.8 quarts. I got a hose on my plunger here, just about to the bottom, so we'll see if it's enough to get the fill or not. I might have to open a second one just to top it off, you know? But we'll see how much this can grab from the bottom, if it'll grab just 0.8 of a quart. Still pumping. I used to use squeeze bottles and funnels and try to just put the bottle up here. It's so ridiculous. You can get these things for like $5 or $10. I probably got it at Pep Boys or AutoZone or something. But Amazon, of course, probably less than $5 these days. Suppose I'll throw a link, like always, in the video, in the bottom of this video, for one of these tools, which you could help out my channel just by like getting that one off Amazon or something. Even clicking on it, and you don't even have to get it. You can get anything else off Amazon. It still works out for me, guys. Just to help support the channel, keep these mods coming. As you know, we've had a long journey together, and we're starting to run out of mods. I do still need that. At some point, it isn't a I'm still pumping, Jesus. At some point, I need the Grimspeed charge pipe. But again, that's not a priority either. Just like the fogs aren't a priority anymore. Yeah, I mean, even if this takes a while, it's comfortable. It's much easier than some methods that you use if you don't have the proper tools. I'm just relaxing, just pumping and pumping. I'm surprised I haven't pumped this whole bottle out yet. And you can get tricked by the drip if it's your hose is sitting in it. It starts dripping off the hose and you think it's full. So I can hold it to the top. Let me get this a good angle here. That's not right. These damn angled YouTube holders. Okay, I'm holding it to the top of the hole so I don't influence the bottom threads for the drip factor. Get that out of the way even. Perfect. Oh my god, I'm gonna need a second quart probably. There we go. Woo! Pump extra, extra. Boom, right there. You make sure that you got enough, you know. And that's it. Dang, let's see. It's pretty hard to like get this to go back in too, I know that. Probably have to waste this little bit in the tube. You break an air seal. So I'm not worried about it dripping or nothing. That's what it's supposed to do. I'll just do this. Just because gear oil stinks way more than engine oil. Here it comes. And you can see my extension hose. It's gonna flip out and get my exhaust wet. I know it, right there. Both ends dripping. If I dare, I'll pump it a little bit to speed up the process. Clear out the hose, there we go. There we go. And I'll keep letting it drip there. I'll do a moisture, oh shit. There we go, moisture save on that. The quart still definitely feels like it has some in there. So, whoa, it's so clumsy, this crap. Okay, gotta get two-hander, there we go. Sealing that, the last bit off. I'll pause it and come back when we're gonna do our final torques. All right, that's a nice steady drip. Let me flip this around, the holder angle is not right. Nice steady drip. I will, no point in trying to stop it first. It'll keep dripping. So, whoa, I don't want to drop that in there. There we go. Perfect. Beautiful, really nice. I love this job because it's so relaxing. There's almost no stress in breaking anything. Just, you know, use the jack trick if anybody's doing it at home. You'll just thank me later because you won't be spraining your shoulders out and just trying with all your might to bust loose that factory Loctite stuff. So, let me get the last torque on this bad boy. And then the easy part is done. Then I'm gonna look into the tranny issue. I do need you guys to, I forget what I was asking you guys. Oh yeah, I'm just kinda thinking to be safe, I could get the drain plug. But then again, I bet it's fine to reuse it. Almost there. I don't like, this thing is like not snug in there. I don't like it, but it probably won't slip. There we go. All right. Yeah, screw it. I'll bump it up to 40. You talk me into it. Okay, Oh, it's already close enough to 40. All right, I guess I really, really trust that that's fine. It's 40 instead of 36 or whatever. I'm gonna get a nice microfiber to clean off extra good. Then I'll check like tomorrow or the next day and just check for any drips, and I'm sure I'll be 100%. And that's how you do the rear end on a 2015 WRX. And again, the oil I used, right there. Only 10 or 11 bucks a quart. It's a lot cheaper than aftermarket stuff. And it's for professionals.